Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Anna Does Design. Today, we're going to be building this calendar. This calendar is made with auto layout, so we're going to put some of the things we've learned from auto layout to the test. You can drag this calendar, and it should grow with it. We'll get to all that, so let's go ahead and get started. The colors I used, you do not need to use. You can pick your own colors. That's up to you. I have made these chevrons. You can go through any of my icon videos to see how I build icons. But I'm just going to duplicate them when I'm there, when I have them out. That's the only thing I want to call out that I've built prior to this. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the month, January. After that, I'm going to grab both of these chevrons. I'm going to press Command C and I'm going to drop them in by pressing Command V. Next thing I'm going to do is just put them where I want them for now. And then I'm going to press Shift A. So I'm putting them in an auto layout. Remember, when you have an auto layout, what you're doing in this auto layout panel, like I've said before in my other auto layout video, affects the inside of the box. As you can see, frame 16 is an auto layout. Let's name this date. If I do 18, or if I drag this 18, it's affecting what's inside of the box. So the chevrons and the month. With that being said, you can see that they're bottom aligned in the left corner. I want to put them center. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to type out the dates. Monday, I'm going to start with the M. I'm going to make them the size I want. 16 is our base. I'm going to probably make these 14. And I'm going to make them semi-bold, as you can see here. I'm going to press Shift A and put them in an auto layout. Remember, this frame affects what's inside. I'm going to name this day, week. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to make them 24 by 24. I want to keep it in a box. This is really important, making sure that the auto layout is centered. This is going to be super important for when we want to make this responsive. Next thing I'm going to do is I am going to change the color of it. I have just some colors here that I use. They're accessible. I've made it this purple color. You can do whatever you want to do. What I'm going to do now is drag it by holding Shift and Option. Shift will make sure that it's dragging on the correct X axis. If I let go of Shift, I can move this anywhere around. I'm going to hold back Shift and put it right next to it. There is no space between. I'm going to take both of the days of the week and I'm going to put them in an auto layout. Shift A. Days. Now, what that means is it makes it really easy to make sure that when I duplicate these days, they go in a row and they all have zero space between. One thing I do want to note is in order to go through the layers, if you see me press enter, I'm going into the children of days week. If I press enter again, I'm going into the child of the day week. I'm going to press shift enter. That's going to bring me back up to the parent, which is day week. Shift enter brings me to the days week parent. Now, I want to acknowledge that I'm going to press enter again. I am in this auto layout panel. I'm going to turn off the padding. Because I've already set it to 24 by 20 for the frame size. So I don't need to have padding there because it may not be 8. It may not follow that. So I just turned it off. I'm going to take this month and I'm just going to press Command D. Make it 7 times. I think that's more than 7. And I'm going to change them accordingly. Monday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. You can order your calendar any way that you want. Next thing I'm going to do is I am going to drag these down. And I'm going to rename this by pressing Command R and make it day number. And I'm just going to repurpose this because it's really easy to repurpose and rebuild. So I'm going to, again, watch my layer panel. I'm going to press Enter, Enter. I'm in the text. This is important to acknowledge. I'm going to change this to 16, regular. And I'm going to make them a darker blue color. Trust the process. Okay, I'm going to do something that might be crazy, but I'm going to duplicate it again. Shift A, put it in a row. Again and again. We have 5 rows. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press the frame 16, which I'm going to rename calendar days. So as you can see in the layers panel, enter, I'm in the text. I'm going to press shift on Monday, so it's not selected. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. I'm going to open a plugin called Add Numbers to Text. I have number selected. I've already used this, so all you do is select number. then you make sure it starts at 1. And then as you can see here, it's a preview. It's going to go all the way to 30. And I'm going to apply it. Now that they're all changed, I'm just going to change these ones manually because it's probably easier. 31, 1. I hold command and make it really easy. As you can see, if I hold command, it brings me to the next one. 3 in the actual text. 4. Okay. The prior dates and the forward dates, we want to acknowledge that they're not going to be in this month. So we're going to select them. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and the 31. I'm holding shift. And I'm going to change the color to something, let's say this one. I don't know if that's necessarily accessible. So let's bump this down a little bit. They don't look like they're the same color. They probably fall into the accessibility category. We can check with Stark and see if this is accessible by ensuring we're touching the text. It is accessible. Great. So now we have our month and our days. Great. We're almost done. We just need to make the buttons and we will make the finalizing touches by making this all in an auto layout. So let's start on the buttons. All you have to do is press T for text, type in save or whatever you want your button to say. Shift A it, put it in a auto layout, name this button. And then I'm going to change this text to 14. I'm going to make it semi-bold, maybe medium. Let's do semi-bold. We're going to change the text color to, I have a really light purple that you can't see. And I'm going to change the button, the fill of it, to be the purple that I've been using. I've made a change to the text color of the button to make sure that it is accessible. But the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change the padding. Let's say I want 24 on the sides. 8's fine on the top for me. I'm going to change the corner radius to 8. Maybe 6. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a shadow. I can do this by pressing Beautiful Shadows, which is a plugin. You can change anything you want in here. I'm just going to make it really simple for the time being. Press Apply. Okay, so now we have our button. That's going to go at the bottom. We're also going to make our save button, which is going to be no background, and it's going to be that purple text color that we've been using, the purple main, this one. And we're going to remove the shadow of the overall button. So now we have two buttons. We can throw them in an auto layout and what we're going to do here is we're going to make this auto, which is known as space between and flexbox for developers. And we're going to name this buttons. Okay. So now we have everything we need and let's just start building with auto layout. So we have our calendar days and our days of the week. I want to make sure that these are grouped together so they stay with no padding between them. So I'm going to press Shift A. As you can see here, there is no vertical gap between the items. I'm going to hold all of these, the buttons, the date, the frame. Oh, let's name this month. Days. We're going to take the date, the days, and the buttons, and we're going to hold Shift A. And now they are going to be in an auto layout. I'm going to make this auto layout in the center. We're going to start refining these so we can make it a little bit more, we can make it responsive. So now it's in frame 16. I'm going to name this calendar. And I am going to do 16 padding, oops, not 166, 16 padding, 16 padding on the top and the bottom. And I'm going to have it fill of white and then make the corners, let's say 12. I am going to put a shadow on it so we can see it's a little elevated. And then, oops, I'm not even looking at the center. And then apply it. We are going to mess with the center of this. I want this to be, let's say I want this to actually be 12. I do want them, these buttons, to not span the entire outer frame calendar. I want them to only stay 12 pixels away from one another. And I am going to fill the calendar so that this can move accordingly. I'm going to fill this container. I'm going to set this to middle. And then I'm going to press enter on the parents. I'm actually only going to select the days. I'm going to make it fill center again. You can keep it up or down. However you want your design to be aligned, that's up to you. Press enter again and ensure that the fill is for the frame of the day's week. And you'll see why. Same thing here. I'm going to fill, press go into center, press enter. I want the day number to fill the entire frame of calendar days because that's the outer frame. Then if I press enter one more time, I want the day week to fill the entire frame of the day number. Therefore, it's going to sit in the middle at all times. Make the buttons fill as well. As you can see, everything's set to fill. Therefore, the calendar actually adjusted for that because it's set to hug. Remember, the inner contents are going to behave based on the outer frame. That's what auto layout's doing. So that means the whole calendar shrunk because the inner dates and days and month are set to fill. And therefore, it's only filling this entire days frame. And this day frame is filling the entire calendar frame. If I make the calendar frame larger, the days begin to stretch, which is exactly what we want. Some things to note here, I did add spacing between the days of the week and the actual calendar days. I am going to make this 8. And I'm going to make these, press enter, 8 as well, and the entire frame it as well. So now we have a little bit more padding and spacing. And as you can see here, we have a responsive calendar that when you make it larger or smaller, the outer frame called calendar, the inner contents will react accordingly. And they are all set to fill. So remember, let's say this is fixed right now, right? If we set it to hug, it's going to smush in all the content. If we set it to bring it out, it's going to go back to fixed. The inner workings, or the days and the calendar days, are also set to fill, so they're going to stretch their frames accordingly. And that's it. That's our calendar. Thanks for coming to Anna Does Design.